Let me explain something to you, sir. Me and him and him and him. We used to go to the grocery store. They didn't have these lazy-ass girls like they do at the Walmart now, wanting to go home. You know, boop, boop. What time are we getting off? I don't know. I'm tired. Boop. I'm sick of this job. Boop. We had a beehive hair woman. She worked at every store. I don't know how she did it. This woman was dedicated to the grocery business. She had a beehive hairdo and a manual cash register, and this woman could go.
This chicken ain't working. My sister made some of that.
She's like Jerry Lee Lewis on that damn thing. Ring up a big-ass grocery cart full of groceries, and then pull up the receipt and go, damn, $40. And everybody drop stuff and go, $40? Damn, who spent $40 at the grocery store? They must be having company. And your mama would go,
$40?
And all the fun cereals ass went back to the shelf. Raisin Bran was going home, Lucky Charms ass was back on the shelf. Spend $40 at the grocery store, go home with cereal and lard. With no debit ass cards. Here, put every bit of information about me on one card so when I get to hell, they'll know me. Boop, boop, boop. Where can I put my forehead and my right hand? Boop. Ooh, I've never read the 13th chapter of Revelation. I'm Catholic. Boop. But no credit cards. Sears might send you one, but you'd max it out on a freezer first thing. Spend 20 years paying for a $40,000 freezer. Because you had one cousin said he could kill enough deer to keep it full of venison. You get the freezer, he gets drafted, goes to Vietnam, and you look at the same box of Fudgesicles for the next 4 years. Waiting on that ass to get back from Da Nang. Vietnam was a war in the 60s. It went a little better than what we got going in Iraq right now. So your mama would go,
$40? I guess I'll have to write a check.
Nobody had ever seen a check. Beehive hair woman would panic.
Fred Front! Fred Front! She's got a check! Fred Front! Fred Front!
This large man would come running out of the meat department. He looked kind of like Junior from Texas Chainsaw Massacre. He'd go, who's got a damn check?
She does! She does!
He'd run to a makeshift office with a half door and get the mandatory half tie. Came down about right here. Didn't match a pair of pants in the whole damn Commonwealth of Kentucky. He'd have chicken blood all over him in a tie. And he'd grab your mama's check, never even look at a driver's license. And suddenly Junior from Texas Chainsaw Massacre would pull out a pen and he was Alan Greenspan. It was good as gold. And a little 22-year-old would two-bag them groceries and push them out to the car for you. And you'd get in a hot-ass station wagon and listen to Johnny Cash on the way home. It was America.